actually took this idea and he went on a course to learn how to draw cartoons. Yeah, it's quite brilliant. And customers actually say to him, can I keep that? So he charges them for the cartoons. Let's finish on metaphor. Driving around this morning, there was lots of politicians already at the moment, and that isn't going to go anywhere. It's going to be there till what, 6th of May? Is that the likely, 6th of May? And if you start, because they've been all trained, these politicians, people like me and Dee and Sue getting at them, and they all start talking metaphorical language. Well, it's a bumpy road ahead, right? We don't want to sit there with our head in the sand on a bumpy road, you know. So these kind of metaphorical languages, and almost everything is a metaphor, actually connect at a different level than logic. So try and think of these kind of things and listen to the language that people use. Right? Listen to how people describe things all the time. And political cliches, but metaphorical language, they're things I'm looking up. You know, all those kind of things. So that's a very positive thing. So sketchpad selling, story selling, and be aware of the metaphors that people use. Okay? No input, no output. I'll give you some ideas this evening. I'm just going to leave you a couple of things to take away. How many people have bought a non-fiction business self-help book in the last 30 days and read it? Good. Right? Get ahead of the game, straight away. Straight away. I'll give you three that if you haven't read, I think you should. First one's by Grand Rollins. No, sorry. Could I be that obvious?
Three books that
I find very useful. First one is a book called Influence by Robert Cialdini. Robert Cialdini, Influence. University professor of psychology in California wrote a book on how marketing and all those sales things and all those people influence us. And it was a book to protect ourselves against these manipulations. Forget it, use it, right? It's brilliant. It's a very interesting book. Second one is Tipping Point. Malcolm Gladwell, heard of that one? Yeah. Kind of links in with Grant. Right? 10.5 years ago, he's written a few more since then, Tipping Point. Very interesting book. Is it anyone who's about networking? You've got to read that, Malcolm Gladwell. And the third one is by a man who I hold in extremely high esteem, probably the cleverest man I've ever met. Richard Bandler. Persuasion Engineering. Right? It's weird. It's not like any other sales book you've ever read. But Persuasion Engineering by Richard Bandler. Definitely recommend it. And he told me to say that. Unconsciously. I'll leave you with one thought. Years ago, I was lucky enough to do some work in California. And California is like anywhere else on the planet. And I was walking down a street in San Francisco. And there was a guy walking towards me on this t-shirt. Right? It's funny how these things stick in your mind, isn't it? Just a brief glimpse and this sticks in your mind, right? On this t-shirt was written this phrase. And this is a phrase I've taken on board and I think about, and it what gets me through some of the tough days and the difficult days, and I'd like to give it and share it with you, right? Dream big, work hard, plan well, smile always. Thank you.
Thank you, Grant, for that very informative and entertaining presentation. Good Lord. Yes.